Hey Cafe Crew, it's Colin Smith here, and today I'm going to show you how to create a dispersion splatter effect. Now this kind of effect has become very popular, you're kind of seeing it everywhere, and there's a lot of different things we can do. Splatters, we can do dispersions, we can do disintegration by using different types of brushes. And the effect is actually really easy. I'm gonna show you how to do it right now. So what I've got is I've got an image here that I grabbed from Adobe Stock, which is a great source for images. You can actually download the watermarked versions and experiment with them for free. And if you choose, you can also license them. And if you wanna get 10 free images from Adobe Stock, check out the link underneath. All right, let's get started. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make two copies of this particular image. So let me just zoom it out a little bit so we can fit it on the screen. And I'm gonna hit Control J and Control J again. So that's twice. If you're on Mac, that would be Command J. And let's just call this one background. Well, actually we'll call this one outside. And we're gonna call this one inside. And you'll see why. Okay, so we're gonna start with the outside one. First thing we're gonna do is grab our lasso and just make a selection around our person. It doesn't have to be precise. That's good enough. Let me just fill that in a little bit so it's not so weird. Okay, there we go. And now we wanna fill with content aware. So we're gonna choose Shift Delete and at Shift Backspace on Windows. Choose Content Aware. Click OK. Control D. All right, great. So the next thing we want to do is the inside. So what we're going to do is actually add some color here. So I'm going to choose filter right now. And under filter, I'm going to choose liquify. And what we're going to do is we're just going to drag this out to give it some color. So why don't I just increase the size a little bit? We've got a pretty high pressure there, and we're going to start with this forward warp tool. So what we're going to do is just grab and we're just dragging this out to create pixels. See what we're doing here? That's all we're doing. Just adding some color. And depending on how far you want to disperse, you can pull this a long way or you could just do it a short distance. It's entirely up to you. So I'm just going to start here just kind of pulling these out. And that noise you hear, I'm actually using a Wacom Cintiq, so that's my pan on my tablet is what you can hear right there. Great, so I want to do this leg here, but I don't want to mess up the front part of that, so I'm going to grab the freeze warp, or the freeze tool actually, and just paint here with this, a freeze mask. And that's just going to protect that front part. Grab my forward warp tool again. And then just drag back. And that's giving us the effect. That's great. That's what we want. Now we're going to click OK. Okay, so now we've got the inside and the outside. What we want to do is we want to hide these just by masking them. So I'm just going to hold down the Alt key. That's Option on Mac, Alt on Windows, and then click the Mask. Let's do the same thing for this one. Alt Option, click on the Layer Mask. All right, so here's our image now, and we're getting ready to apply our dispersion splatter. Now what we need to do is use a brush, and I know some tutorials just kind of start, say, grab a brush. I'm gonna show you how to get a brush right now. In fact, if you're an Adobe Creative Cloud subscriber, you have access to a bunch of different brushes and assets. So click on the Creative Cloud under here, under Assets, go here, and we can try Splatter Brush. And you want to make sure we're in the market there, and you can see there we go. There's a whole bunch of free brushes that you can grab. Now the way to add them is we go through our Creative Cloud library. So the way to do that is we click on here, and we can add to library. Now I've created a library called Brush. You can click on Create Library if you don't have one, just like that, and type in Brush. I'm not gonna do it again because I have one, but I'm just gonna select Brush right there, and that's all I need to do. And that's gonna download to my brush just by clicking on it. There, see that? You can see it syncing. We can do the same here. And that's syncing. So you can actually go through and just download your brushes. Then when you're ready, we could actually see what we've got here if you want. Open up our library panel. And you can see under the brushes, there's our brushes. All right, so why don't we select that brush right there? We're just gonna double click on it. And you'll notice that that brush is going to appear right there with our brush tool selected. There's our brush. Okay, we wanna modify this a little bit. So let's go into our brushes panel here. Under, just go to window brush if it's not showing. And we want to do some adjustments to this brush. First thing we want to do is choose shape dynamics. We're going to turn our size jitter up quite a bit. And also set our control to pen pressure because I'm going to be using a Wacom pressure sensitive pen. And you'll see that there, pen pressure. And then other things we might want to do is do a little bit of angle jitter, just give it a little bit of randomness. And then where it's really going to happen here is going to be under the scattering. So let's get some scattering going. And we're going to give it a little bit more count and a count jitter. So that's going to give it some nice randomness. And also I'm going to set this to pen pressure. Excellent. All right. Now we just want to make the brush smaller. So I'm going to grab the left bracket key and just drop this down a little bit. About there is looking good. All right. Let's pop our layers panel open and just tear it off. And I'm just going to hide everything else, and we'll just put our layers panel here, just so you can see what's going on. So now it's time to add our effects. We're going to click where it says outside. And now we're going to go and make sure our brush is selected, or with white as the foreground, opacity 100. And let's play around with this. In fact, I'm going to make it a little smaller, and I'm just going to start going around those edges there. And what it's doing is it's applying that texture from the outside in there. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make the brush even smaller and just kind of have a smaller brush right up on those edges there. And that's just by tapping that bracket key. Right on the edges, we want a smaller brush. All right, great. Now we've kind of taken away from the back there, but we want to have those little particles projecting out into the back. So we're now going to click on the layer mask on the inside one. And I'm going to make the brush just a little bit bigger right now. There we go. And we're just going to go around those edges and add a little bit of dispersion there. And see how it's starting to work now. Now I'm going to imagine the smaller particles are probably going to travel a little bit further. So now I'm going to do a smaller brush here. Let me grab a really small brush. And I'm just going to put some really tiny ones. In fact, we're going to kind of do it in a little shape here. See that? So we can get little streams coming out. And that kind of adds to the interest there, like little waves coming out. See that? And there we have it, guys. It's that simple to do that kind of dispersion splatter. Now, feel free to experiment with different types of brushes and you're going to get different results, and also try different images. Download 10 free images from Adobe Stock. And also, if you want to become a Stock contributor, check out the link underneath. So thanks for watching, guys. If you like these kind of tutorials, I've got a new tutorial at least once a week. Hit the subscribe button right now. Hit that little bell icon if you are a subscriber, and then you'll be informed when I get the new tutorials. If you like this, smash that like button into dust. Add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. Also, let me know what you'd love to learn. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.